So most of you know that we did a rockathon already like a couple weeks ago, and that rockathon was to raise money for different people in the village that needed some assistance or just a little bit of help. We've all been in that situation. That's Orion talking to us. Anyway, we had so many people come out to help out that we actually had to do a second one because so many people had put their money out to have their song reviewed, but the internet kept cutting out and we had different situations, but we had already done 15 hours. So we came back for a second rockathon, and this is one of the videos from that. Again, you'll notice us getting a little bit tired, so have a little patience with us, but I think we did pretty good this time. So thanks for everybody for coming out to help out. And we were actually able to help somebody get in a situation where they were able to save their house. They didn't lose their house. And a couple other people that those stories are pretty cool. So yeah, shout out to you.
It Ain't Like That by Alice in Chains. Are we ready?
Yes, pull it up there because I'm adding two more to the list.
Thank you.
by Lane Staley. Obviously! Oh, my goodness gracious. His vocal style was so unique. Like, the guy... So, we saw them at the Korn show. And the guy that replaced him, no disrespect to the big homie, he did a great job. But, I mean, he was not this individual. Uh-huh. This guy is like... I don't know how to describe, like, his vocals. They're kind of haunting and they're kind of... they drag you to some place. I can't really... I don't really understand exactly how... I'm getting frustrated because I don't know the exact adjective to describe what he does vocally. But it's something that only he does. And it's not... I'm getting meta here, but it's more like from his soul. Like, Maynard has a distinct voice as well, but that's because he's just objectively, artistically gifted vocally. Mm-hmm. Whereas this guy, what he does with his voice is like it's literally his soul. It's dark and obviously, you know,
tortured vocals.
Yeah. But I don't have the exact words for it because it's something else. But he was one of those guys, like, we'd always have this conflict when you listen to rappers because they would talk about, you know, gangster shit and da 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 da. And we're like, man, he's not real. He's not really living that. And sometimes I feel with rock and roll, like, there's a whole shtick of being miserable or dark or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yeah, you're not that guy. Like, there's one guy I'm thinking about right now, brilliant guy, intelligent lyricist, dark as hell. But then it's like when he takes off the makeup and all the rest of it, like, he's a regular dude. And I'm not mad at him for that. Like, he understands he's playing a role. This dude was not playing a role. Like, he was suffering. Mm-hmm. Like, period. Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that that's good. It made great art and all of us benefited from it. But at the same time, it's like, yikes, you know, and obviously he was not able to overcome that. And inshallah, he's at peace now. But really, really, really good song.
What did you give it?
This is a 9.9 to me.
9.9. It's a 7.4 for me.
What?
Yeah.
What happened?
I just didn't think it was that great. I never Sorry.
I'm not even going to say anything because I want to stay married.
Aww.